We left Lake Havasu City, headed for Parker, Arizona. We were driving on Highway 95 and rounded the end of Lake Havasu, where we stopped to admire the view in the Bill Williams River National Wildlife Refuge. The scenery here, just off the side of the road, was stunning. Wildflowers were beginning to bloom amongst the rocks, and we were surprised to see lupins, just like we have back in BC. These massive rock formations loomed over us as we passed through Parker Strip. We spent the night in Parker at the Blue Water Casino and Resort. We boondocked in their parking lot. Be forewarned, their parking lot is not level and you'll need to level your RV if you use it. The next day we headed to Quartzsite where we stayed in the long-term visitors area, paying the $40 for the two-week pass so we could dump our tanks and fill up with water. We found a secluded spot under a tree and took the dogs for a walk.
You want to go for a walk? You guys want to go for a walk?
You
want
to go for a walk?
You
want to
go for a walk?
Look at mom. Hey, you want to go for a walk? Are you sure? Yeah. Okay, let's go. Come on, let's go.
It was nice to be able to get out and wander the desert. You'll notice we're wearing our big puffy winter coats because it was not warm. It was downright chilly. The next day we hit the road again on our way to Wickenburg. The snow on those hills was not a promising sight. We arrived in Wickenburg just before it started to rain and had time to run around the town and look at the sights. So far, for me, Wickenburg is my favorite town in Arizona. I love the cowboy theme, the spectacular scenery, the wonderful shopping, the people are so friendly. It's hard to believe these oranges were covered in snow the next morning. In downtown Wickenburg, you will find life-sized bronze sculptures by the artist J. Seward Johnson. There are 6 large bronze sculptures and 16 linking pieces, smaller ones like this Gila monster. You can get a free walking map tour from the Tourist Information Center, which is located in the old train station. The larger sculptures include a button with a narrative from the Arizona State Historian Marshall Trimble on the history of Wickenburg. And remember, there is no fishing from the bridge in the Hassayampa River. A chilly night was spent in the McDonald's parking lot before we headed to Phoenix for the next part of our journey.